文郡位于英国英格兰西南部，这里有美丽的海岸线，还有充足的阳光。
Lots of light coming in. We're obviously pointing perfectly due south to maximise solar gain. And we have natural solar shading from the green roof above to help keep it a little bit cooler.
这是一栋绿色能源住宅，它会是人类未来零碳排新生活的方式之一吗？
Where did the inspiration come from?
I think it started from when we got married on the site 7 years ago. So we had a world-inspired, beautiful tents sitting in this, you know, in the spot. And afterwards, we thought, well, why don't we try and build an off-grid home?
I wouldn't say we're eco warriors, no. But for us to build a house that's creating its own energy is kind of the dream. We're fueling our travel with any spare hydrogen that we have. We're harvesting our rainwater from the roof. We're managing our own waste.And we also have a borehole on site, so we're drawing water up from the ground. So we're completely off-grid. There's no cables, no pipes in or out of our house.
看和从事建筑业的丈夫 Nick 花了7年的时间完成梦想中的蓝图。住宅内有一处能源储存房，利用太阳能板储存能源，并把多余的转换成氢气，以便冬天使用。
Welcome to the engine room.
So this is where the house is powered up.
Indeed, yes. That elevation is dealing with all water treatment, water storage, hot water cylinder. The wall behind you is dealing with all the electrical boards and BMS panels and all the inverters from the solar panels on the roof. And in the middle of the room, we have all our hydrogen plants. So the electrolysis plant, the hydrogen fuel cell sits in the middle of the room. This is where we're making our hydrogen.
除了住宅使用，连汽车所用的动力也能自给自足。
Hydrogen.Enables you to make the most of your renewables, and that is key for for moving us away from fossil fuels and taking us into that more into that greener future. Sun doesn't always shine, wind doesn't always blow. However, if you've always got hydrogen there as your backup and your store, it means you can make the most of your renewables when you have got it available. We lose an awful lot of renewable power in the UK just from like curtailed wind turbines when the grid can't accept any more back. In my ideal world, if I had a magic wand, would be to stop wasting that energy and to create hydrogen instead.
氢能源的发展快速，但为了保护土地，重新种植树木成本高达100万英镑。很显然的，大多数的人根本买不起这种住宅。
I think we're still living, you know, in the dark ages a little bit because we need to become more aware that this kind of technology actually exists.
有了新技术，凯和 Nick 更希望能和更多的人分享。他们建立了小学生参观平台，让小孩子从小养成绿色能源的生活概念。但他们也明白，还有一段很长的路要走。
There's some pretty ambitious targets, environmental targets, that we need to meet over the next 10 to 15 years. So unless there's government support or subsidies, I think we're really going to struggle to meet those.
在英国有40%的二氧化碳排放来自家庭，从根本上考虑生活方式值得深思。去年在环保少女桑伯格的带动下，全球连线掀起气候变迁的抗议行动。当时英国学子齐聚伦敦街头，手持标语要求政府有所作为。时任英国首相梅伊在卸任之前做出承诺，向国会提交气候变迁法修正案，将在2050年达到零碳排标准。这也是八大工业国组织中第一次有国家明确定下零排放方针，并写进法案。
Well, I believe that we have a moral duty to leave this world in a better condition than what we inherited.
过去6年，英国燃煤发电占比已从30%降到仅剩2%，现在誓言要在2050年达到近零碳排的标准。
So what will a zero emissions future look like? Well, beef consumption might need to fall by 90%. Meat production is a big contributor to greenhouse gases. Around 38 million petrol and diesel vehicles will be removed from the roads, replaced by electric alternatives. Airline flights will have to be drastically reduced or new fuels introduced. And gas boilers in 25 million homes will have to go, replaced with low carbon heating.
今年初，英国政府扩大离岸风电布局，打算在2030年前将风力占比拉高到30%。去年五月，更创下工业革命后的纪录，整整一星期没有启动燃煤发电厂，完全依靠再生能源供电。如果2025年零碳排放政策达标，英国夸口将能一口气减低全球气温摄氏1.5度。美国有线电视 CNN 估计，英国政府为了零碳排放标准，将至少花费1兆英镑。
The UK can and must go faster, and we must see some radical changes in policy.
原定于今年11月举行的联合国气候峰会 COP26 因新冠疫情延期，主办国英国确定改在明年11月举行。这个引领工业革命的国家要如何变身成为全欧的绿色新典范？这可能不只是时程表的排定而已，如何从生活中改变和执行，诚如建造绿色住宅看似美好，但工程浩大。